It takes a village to raise a child, and I agree. It takes imperfect parents to show you the right way, and perfect parents to show you the wrong way, both necessary for a strong base. Follow me now. How else will we learn how to love our significant other, argue with them, and then love them again? Because marriage and parents aren't perfect. It's a pull, it's a push, it's a blessing worth working. And in those lessons, we teach our children how to embrace their husband or embrace their wife. Our children will learn from our accomplishments to be better than us. Our children will learn from our mistakes to be better than us. It takes a village to raise a child, and I agree. It takes a Grammy, a nanny, a meemaw, a nana, a tata, a pop-pop, a peepaw, and a pawpaw to raise a child. Our grandparents are the gatekeepers to our culture, your culture. Mothers and fathers with our constantly busy schedules, it's okay to call the reinforcements. They're storytelling while prepping lunch on the back porch then. They're the anchors to the life that we live, like Uncle Mo and Auntie Tita's vinyl green couch in Southern Cali, Pop in my mom's kitchen with the dirt floor back in Dedido, Nanny's house in the small town of Doe Run, Grammy and Pop-Pop's screened-in porch in Lee County, have all played classrooms to our brothers, our sisters, our cousins, our neighbors, our friends, and our family. And each home has hosted friends from around. Take a look at the pictures on the wall. It was Facebook before Facebook was. It takes a village to raise a child, and I agree. It takes brothers and sisters to make you tougher. It takes brothers and sisters to make you more compassionate. It takes a childhood friend to grow old with, and they become a crutch to survive your childhood upbringing. And as the year pass, they become a influential piece to your child's upbringing. It takes a village to raise a child, and I agree. It takes a school teacher who's not worried about straightening out the attitude of little Bobby, because she knows little Bobby's parents, and trust me, little Bobby don't want his parents knowing about his classroom interference. It takes a village to raise a child, and I agree. It takes a church, and when I say church, I don't mean a physical building. I mean a true congregation of people who all share the same feeling, because it's about your relationship with God, not who's in or out that building. Because the lessons our children learn at Sunday school should not be limited to just Sunday school. It should be lessons taught every day by our grandparents, our parents, our brothers, our sisters, our cousins, our neighbors, our friends, our family. Because it takes a village to raise a child, and I agree.